Good day, students. Welcome to math.serve.com. This is part one of our fraction hack series, and we're going to be focusing on how to divide fractions. Do not forget to visit our website at math.serve.com for access to a wide variety of tutorials ranging from algebra to calculus. All right, so the fraction hack that we're going to be using to divide fractions today is known as the drop, change, flip process. Okay, drop, change, flip. Now let's apply it to a situation, and then we're going to take a look at some examples applying this drop, change, flip procedure. Okay, what if you were asked to find the result of dividing 5 by 5, 5 divided by 5? Okay, 5 divided by 5 is simply 1, because when you divide two identical numbers, you end up with 1, all right? Now, applying the drop change flip procedure here, first thing you want to do is express these two numbers as fractions. So you can write 5 as 5 over 1, and then divided by 5 over 1, all right? Now, what you're going to do is you're going to drop the dividend, and then you're going to change the division to a multiplication, the inverse procedure. And then you're going to flip the divisor 1 over 5. Okay? So you drop the first fraction or the dividend. You change the divide to a times. And then you flip or reciprocate the divisor. Okay? So if you do that, simply multiply across. 5 times 1 is 5. 1 times 5 is 5. 5 divided by 5 is equal to 1. Okay, because 5 goes here once, 5 goes here once, 1 over 1 is 1. So we see that our procedure is in harmony with what we thought of earlier. Okay, now let's go ahead and take a look at some examples. So example number 1, we're going to be dividing an integer by a fraction. Integer divided by a fraction. So let's see if we can apply this drop change flip hack to this situation. Okay, so for example one, we're to find the value of 3 divided by 1/2. Okay, now in this situation we have a numerator and a denominator. In the example I showed you, we had a dividend and a divisor, okay? So the numerator here is the dividend and the denominator is a divisor, all right? So we can write this problem as 3 divided by 1/2, okay? Now before you apply the drop change flip procedure, you must express the two numbers as fractions. Okay, so 3 is not a fraction, so we can just write it as 3 divided by 1 is equal to 3, and then 3 over 1 divided by 1 over 2. All right, now we are ready to apply the drop change flip procedure. You drop the dividend as it is, you change your division to a times, and then you flip the divisor. Okay, so you flip it, becomes 2 over 1. Now what do? You multiply across. Numerator times numerator, 3 times 2, 6. 1 times 1, 1. 6 divided by 1 is 6. And there goes your answer. Okay, let's take a look at another example. Example 2. We are going to be dividing a fraction by an integer. Okay, so example 2, we have fraction divided by an integer. In example 1, we had integer divided by fraction. Now let's see how we can apply the drop change flip procedure to dividing a fraction by an integer. All right, so what if we were to find the value of 3 over 2 divided by 6. Okay, this looks nicer because it's written in a dividend divided by divisor format horizontally. So we don't need to carry out any rewriting procedure. Okay, so first thing you want to do before you drop change flip is ensure that the divisor and the dividend are written in fraction form. Okay, so 3 over 2 is already a fraction. What is 6 as a fraction? 6 as a fraction is 6 divided by 1. Okay, now we're going to drop change flip. You drop the dividend and then you change the divide to a times and then you flip the divisor to 1 over 6. Okay, the whole idea here is when you're dividing, what you're doing in essence is multiplying by the reciprocal of the denominator. All right, I mean exactly the same thing. All right, so now we'll just multiply across. Multiply across, 3 times 1 is 3, 2 times 6 is 12. Now you notice that we can reduce this fraction. We can divide the numerator and the denominator by the greatest common factor. The greatest common factor of 3 and 12 is 3. So we divide the numerator by 3, divide the denominator by 3, and then your answer is going to become 1 over 4. All right? So there goes your answer. All right, let's take a look at the next example, example 3. For example 3, we're going to divide a fraction by a fraction. Okay, fraction divided by a fraction. So let's see how we can apply the drop change flip procedure in finding the result of dividing a fraction by a fraction. So let's find the value of 6 over 5 divided by 2 over 15. This is written as a numerator denominator orientation vertically. So, in order to apply the drop change flip procedure with ease, let's go ahead and write this horizontally. Okay? The numerator is a dividend, so we have 6 divided by 5, 6 over 5, divided by the denominator is our divisor, so we have 2 over 15. Now we have two fractions written horizontally. Now it's easy for us to apply the drop change flip procedure. Now, let's go ahead and apply it. You drop the dividend as it is, 6 over 5. You change the divide to a times, and you reciprocate or flip the divisor. So you have 15 over 2. Okay? Now, what we'll do next is multiply across numerator times numerator. 6 times 15 is 60 plus 30, which is 90. 5 times 2 is 10. Now we can divide by 10. 10 goes here once, 10 goes in at 90, 9 times. All right, so 9 divided by 1 is simply 9, and there goes your final answer. Now let's take a look at example 4. Example 4 involves dividing two mixed numbers, okay? Mixed number divided by a mixed number. So how can we apply the drop change flip procedure to finding the result of dividing two mixed numbers? So let's go ahead and write down the problem. We are to find the result of dividing 5.5 by 2.5. Okay? So this is a nice situation because it's written in a horizontal orientation, the dividend divided by the divisor. The first step in applying the drop change flip procedure is ensuring that you have your dividend and divisor written as fractions. They could be proper or improper. Since we have mixed numbers here, we're going to have to convert our mixed numbers into improper fractions. Okay, so let's go ahead and do 5.5 first. So we multiply the denominator by the whole number, and then we add it to the numerator, and that will be our numerator. Okay, so 2 times 5 is 10, plus 1 is 11. So we have 11 over 2 divided by, so the denominator of your fraction is still going to be your denominator. Apply the same procedure here. We're going to convert this mixed number into improper fraction. Multiply the denominator times the whole number and add the whole number to the numerator of your fraction piece. So we have 2 times 2 is 4, and then 4 plus 1 is 5. 5 over 2. Okay? Now we're good to go. We have a fraction divided by a fraction, although they are improper fractions. Now what we're going to do is drop, change, flip. So we drop the dividend. Go ahead and drop that. You drop the dividend, and then we're going to change the sign to a times and then flip the divisor. All right? So drop the dividend, divide becomes a times, flip or reciprocate your divisor, and you have that. Okay? Now we can multiply across. If we multiply across, we have 11 times 2 is 22, divided by 2 times 5, which is 10. Now, the greatest common factor of these two numbers is 2. So we can go ahead and divide the numerator and the denominator by 2. And that gives us 11 over 5. And if we want to write this as a mixed number, we just simply divide 11 by 5. Remember, the numerator or the top dog goes in the doghouse. Okay, so you put 11 as under the division bars. 5 goes into 11 twice, 2 times 5, 10. And then you subtract 1. 1 is smaller than 5, so you're going to combine these two as a fraction, okay? Combine these two as a fraction, 1 over 5. So our final answer is going to be 2, whole number, remainder 1 over 5. So there goes the result of dividing those two mixed numbers that we had earlier. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. Really appreciate it. Feel free to subscribe to our channel for updates to other cool tutorials such as this. And do post a comment in the comment section to let us know what you think about this clip, or if you have more videos you would like us to make tutorials for. More clips can be found on mathgoodserve.com. Thanks again for watching, and have a wonderful day.